ceremonies. The students, nursing faculty, charter college staff, and you, their families, are all very glad that we have finally reached this hospital. The pinning ceremony has roots from the 12th century, when knights who aided the sick were given a Maltese cross to wear. Today's pinning ceremony is closely tied to an award given to legendary nurse Florence Nightingale. She was awarded the Red Cross of St. George in the 1860s for her tireless work during the Crimean War. Later, the Nightingale School of Nursing at St. Thomas Hospital in London resigned and awarded a badge with the Maltese Cross to all nurses as they completed their program. Today, each student will receive a nursing pin unique to the Associate Nursing Program at Charter College. The pin was designed by graduates from Cohort 1. Faculty will present a rose to each student to represent the fragility of lives they will care for throughout their nursing careers. And the candle given to students will commemorate Florence Nightingale as the lady with the lamp, and symbolize the late night rounds that a nurse makes while on the job. I would like to take the opportunity to welcome our special guests for today, Kathy Jade and Sandra Woods, Deans of Nursing for Charter College, the staff and faculty of Charter College, any representatives of our clinical partners. Thank you all for your part in helping us to establish the quality of the Associate of Applied Science and Nursing program. Please welcome Emily Joaquin, nursing instructor, to present the nursing prayer.
Walk in the plan and it immediately changes. And that's kind of fun. exciting profession, and nothing boring about it ever. I want you to remember to try to take a step back when you work with people and to see the big picture, not just, you know, what's immediately in front of you, but to kind of look at the overall scheme of things. Maybe you find things out about their families. Maybe you're working in something like hospice or home health, but you actually go into the home and find all sorts of things that you don't find out when you're working in the hospital with someone. It's all different. So what is your overall impression? And do you pay attention when that little voice inside you starts talking? Never, never, ever discount that, because it's generally telling you something you need to hear. Pay attention. It's a good guide. And ask yourself, you know, what do I see? What may I miss? What am I not seeing? I mean, just be open and curious. I think curiosity is one of your best tools. Be curious about how this person thinks, how they feel, what their values are. Be listening for what's different maybe about them and what you have in common. You never ever know. And I always like to, and Quaker actually, and William Penn is part of that tradition. I grew up in Pennsylvania, named after William Penn. He once said, "Oh Lord, help me not to despise or oppose what I do not understand." And I have that on my desk actually. I think it's a good reminder for me that when my knee-jerk reaction is, wait, I don't want to do that, or I don't want to listen to that, or I don't like that, to just take a deep breath and relax and listen and see what you find out. You can get beyond yourself, get out of your own way. You often make great discoveries. And it goes along with thinking that stereotypes are walls that we put up beyond which we cannot see. So again, if you're stopped by what you do not understand or what you instinctively oppose, you can't see beyond that. So take a deep breath, open yourself up for new ideas, and keep on trucking. I often think, too, of the Buddhist idea that we learn the most from our enemies. And I don't mean that patient or friend will be an enemy literally, but you don't understand them. Those are the people that you learn the most from. So enjoy it, you know? Welcome them. They have a lot to teach you. And humor. My goodness. I don't think day goes by when we don't laugh a lot at hospice, a lot of times at ourselves. And that's okay. Tell better jokes. I think those are really great things to pull out of your pocket for a patient. You know, humor is not at the expense of another person, but it often helps connect with someone after. It's essential. So I remember actually a patient who died in a couple of days, not likely to remember, asked me to come visit in the chapel. I remember her, she was about to walk up saying, "Tell me a joke, tell me something funny." And the only thing I could think of, because I'm really bad at remembering jokes, was glass top coffins, whether they catch on or not remains to be seen. It wasn't mine. And she laughed, and I thought, well, at least she didn't laugh until she died. Humor is always good. And the other thing I guess I'd like to recommend to everybody, not just nursing students, but nurses, is to always kind. Try to set aside whatever anger sometimes we have or carry with us. Just choose to be kind. It never fails. It's always to your advantage. I think lots of impressions we leave on people, even if we don't agree with them, they're angry at us. If you're kind, you leave a bridge. not fail her. Please don't go into your profession thinking that if someone dies, you will fail them. I have no idea why that happens, when it happens. I have no special knowledge as a chaplain. It's totally a mystery to me, but it does. Who knows? You have not failed them. You have walked with them. You have given them all of the tools that were you had. You have helped explain those tools and given them hopefully a little boost, a little hope, courage. And hope is always sort of, hope for me always lies in the possibility of relationship and connection. Not, you know, sort of the very last breath they take, it's like something they can participate in. Hope is about meaning making, hope is about knowing that they're loved, that they're supported, that you care about them. This is a very important part of hope. It's not hope in what will happen, as in, you know, I can be cured. That's not the most important part of hope, I guess. And when you find people who are angry, I think you've possibly talked about this in class. COVID and on, in politics, in religion, in healthcare, everywhere we see angry people who are lashing out sometimes at the very humanitarian helpers doing God's work. Nurses, doctors, they're taking the brunt of a lot of anger. Again, I'd say just be kind. But when you find someone who's angry, my experience is plant your butt, sit down and listen to you. Just the act of doing that will change a lot. And again, you are demonstrating that you care about them. I'm not saying you this as they're ready to swing at you. No, don't have room to get out of there. But so often they are venting, they want someone to listen, and I can only think in the couple of decades I've been doing chaplaincy, but two times when I was with a person who, in a sense, didn't talk to myself or get angry when I or someone else sat down and listened. And it doesn't take that long. 10, 15 minutes. It's a lot, I know, in the healthcare day. It's very busy, but that's not so much to ask maybe in a moment when you have a break. Go back and sit down and earnestly listen to them and let them know that you care and you're ready to walk the path with them. Anger is something that demands your full attention. So along with that, I keep thinking of the times I would sit with angry people. You know, I'm reminding myself to be calm. I'm not buying into their anger and reacting with them. I'm thoughtfully responding. That's another thing I hope by now maybe you've had a clue about as to not to react, but to respond thoughtfully, compassionately. Sitting and listening is definitely doing that. But I was assured in April that you guys would talk about mirror neurons. Yes, no? Yes. That is a superpower, okay? Totally a superpower. You have the ability just by sitting there to affect your own.
encouragement and your words of wisdom to our nurse graduates. Please welcome Dr. Tina Smith for the presentation of awards.
Thank you.
things live.
Jasmine
Shepherd.
Mahaya Yumam.
Thank you.
once again welcoming Professor Emily Wett Ossie to the stage to lead us in the Florence Nightingale Pledge. Nurse graduates as they enter the nursing profession.